Okay, shalom. Still Shabbat time. Sembet Salam. We left off, ran out of tape. We left off on Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 through 20. Now, I'm just going to sum up what's going on here. We need to separate ourselves and be holy to the Lord. The body is to be a living sacrifice to the Lord. We are to put under subjection our desires of food, our hunger, and our sexual appetite. We are to put that under subjection, for we are to separate ourselves and sanctify ourselves and be holy to the Lord and be a living sacrifice. We must. Now, verse 13, it says, meat for the belly, and the belly for meats, but God shall destroy both it and them. Now the body is not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. Meats you eat, and the belly destroys that, the what you eat. But then the Lord destroys the body, that destroys the... You see, everything comes into subjection to the Lord. If we are not holy to the Lord, then the Lord destroys our belly, our strength, our abdomen. That actually ties into the ram's horn I'll just continue. And God hath both raised up the Lord, and will also raise up us by his own power. See, we are not to be under the power of any. We are to be raised up in his own power, in the power of Jah, in Chayel. Now, know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid. Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh. But he that is joined to the Lord in one spirit, flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body. But he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. What? Know ye not that your body is a temple of Jah, and the Holy Spirit which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body, and in your spirit, which are God's. Gotta separate I myself to the Lord. You know, this is a landed body. We are redeemed. Once again, the structure of law, we are redeemed at a price. Jah is liable for the lend. He lended this body. I is liable. We hold liability to the inheritance. If we do wrong with it, then Jah has every right to destroy that, because it's his. We are a temple created not with hands of man. Now, okay, I didn't do a really good job of going over that, but I figured, I know Brother Yaron is going to be so busy doing some other stuff that I just threw in some of this. I guess let's go to Zechariah, chapter 14, let me first go there. This is going to be interesting. Yeah, have any of the eyes ever been called a pothead? Have any of the brothers or sisters ever been called a pothead? There's a lot more to that. I think. Well, first of all, Potter, we Rasa Adonis has been over that, the potter and the father. And Aenai is to be a pots in the sense that we're vessels to carry the soul, carry the water, the spirit of Jah, and to navigate the seas, right? The holy seas, what? Anyway. And what pottery is usually made of organic matter. And that is exactly what Aenai is. We are pots and pot heads, yes. We seek to have Ras upon our head. We seek Christ in our head, so kind of like the Father's head. Hey, potter's head, pot. Yes, we have Rastafari and Aenai heads. So it's not that bad if they call us pot heads or whatever, because it kind of makes sense. And yes, we are green in the sense that we're going, we're moving, we're on the go. Green means go, and we are to be plants, planted alongside the rivers of water. And nothing shall escape Jah's judgment. So, okay, Zechariah. I'm going to start at verse 16. And it shall come to pass that everyone that is left of all the nations which came against Jerusalem shall even go up from year to year to worship the King, the Lord of hosts, and to keep the feast of the tabernacles. Go up to higher ground. And it shall be that whoso will not come up of all the families on the earth to Jerusalem to worship the King, the Negus, the Lord of hosts, even upon them shall be no rain. No rain to them hoes, right? To the woes. Now, 18, verse 18. And if the family of Egypt go not up and come not, that have no rain, there shall be the plague, wherewith the Lord will smite the heathen that come not up to keep the Feast of Tabernacles. I think that the Feast of Tabernacles, it has been fulfilled, because Feast of Tabernacles, the tabernacle, I guess, because later on it'll connect with the congregation. We are the congregation of the children of Israel that are to meet with Jah at a certain time, at an appointed time. And this is that time. We have met with Jah in the sense that we've been called to this meeting. Now, this shall be the punishment, I'm sorry, verse 19. This shall be the punishment of Egypt and the punishment of all the nations that come not up to keep the Feast of Tabernacles. Nations is it means birth. I don't know if it applies here, but nation in the Latin, it basically means nació, to be born. Now, in verse 20, in that day shall there be upon the bells of the horses. We can interpret in this specific place, the bells are the ringing, the vibrations, like the vibrations, that the sound, maybe the vibrations of Aenai mouth, of Aenai hearts. If we vibrate positively, and the horse could be like the vessel, so there be upon the bells of the horses holiness to the Lord. Once again, separate to the Lord, and the pots in the Lord's house shall be like the bowls before the altar of incense. So we can have bowls before the altar of incense, and the pots in the Lord's house, the pot heads, shall be like the bowls before the altar. Why? Because we shall grow and bear fruit in due season. Yea, every pot in Jerusalem and in Judah shall be holiness to the Lord of hosts. See, so right here it's indicating that the pots will be holiness separate, wholly separate to Jah. So that could very well mean I and I. No. And all they that sacrifice shall come and take of them. And see he therein. See who therein. And in that day there shall be no more the Canaanite in the house of the Lord of hosts. I think this is saying how whoever comes and all they that sacrifice shall come and take of them, of the pots. And the pots are supposed to reflect Jah. We are to be in the image. And when I do the Exodus section, it'll make sense. Now, yes, I'm going to stop there. And I'll be right back and continue on with the rest.